Welcome to Champ Sports Network presentation of Penn State Greater Allegheny Basketball. Good evening, everybody. I'm Al Esch alongside Jeff Wink. We're here on the beautiful campus of Penn State Greater Allegheny in the Wonderland Gym to bring you the contest between Penn State Greater Allegheny and Lehigh Valley. And tonight, both teams come in, though all the Lions from Greater Allegheny, Jeff, they come in off two huge wins, and a couple games back, an even bigger win against Penn State Beaver.
Yeah, Penn State Beaver, I saw them last year. They seem to be the powerhouse in this conference. You might want to say the top Penn State team, at least in the branch campuses, and maybe I think the way that the big boys played, they might have held tough with them too.
Yeah, it was. They beat them here at Wonderland by the score of 87-82 back on January 27th. And the Lions here at Greater Allegheny looking to continue their winning ways here in PSUCA and see if they can't take down this Lehigh Valley team. Lehigh Valley comes in with a record of 9-10 overall, 7-5 in conference, and Greater Allegheny with a record of 6-16 and 5-8 in conference. Starting for Lehigh Valley will be Taj Williams, the 6'2 freshman, Jordan Young, a 5'11 freshman, Derek Chalana, a 6'6 freshman, Brandon Holland, a 5'10 sophomore, and Darrell Kelly, a 6'3 freshman.
A lot of young guys on that.
They're all Lehigh Valley comes in with all freshmen except for two sophomores, Jeff, so it's a young squad.
So the sophomores are the elder statesmen of the bunch.
Yeah. And Greater Allegheny, their starting lineup is number 24, Petrie Addison, a 6'6 junior. Number 33, Aaron Bird, a 6'2 senior. Number 1, Nick Dizon, a 6'5 senior. And number 2, Eric Moody, a 6'1 freshman. And number 23, Peter Olmes, a 6-foot sophomore. So age-wise, Greater Allegheny has the advantage here tonight.
Yeah. It works. See if that works in their favor or not. The experience they're playing at this level.
So we'll step away, and we'll come right back with tip-off in just 1 minute.
I'm Janelle Wright, a Panera Bread customer. I am the mother of 4 children, and I'm a professional violinist. After eating the breakfast power sandwich, I know that I'm fueled for the day, and I feel satisfied. To me, this is the only fresh, wholesome option out there, because the competitors have something that's processed that they're warming up in the microwave. What I love about the breakfast power sandwich are the wonderful ingredients. All-natural egg, the Vermont white cheddar, and smoked ham on freshly baked whole grain bread. Something under 350 calories, and that's awesome. Panera Bread, made today better.
Welcome back to Wonderland Gym on Greater Allegheny's campus. We're ready for tip-off for Lehigh Valley. It will be number 15, Derek Chalana. And for Greater Allegheny, it will be number 1, Nick Dizon will tip-off.
This is proven to everyone here. It doesn't matter if you've called all kinds of high school. When you think of Greater Allegheny, Penn State, not much different than high school. Centers are still big, and for that.
Greater Allegheny, it looks like a false tip.
And looks like Lehigh Valley will get the ball to start the game. Coming down the court is Holland. Goes over into the far wing. Passes down underneath. Shot up and in for two for Greater Allegheny, or Lehigh Valley on top, 2-0 here. It's Greater Allegheny on attack now. Addison with the ball. He passes down underneath for the layup to Dizon and ties it up at two. Down the court is Young, dribbling on the wing. Passes off to Kelly. Kelly in the lane, throws it up, no good. Rebound brought down by Addison for Greater Allegheny. Addison dribbles up court, tries to drive down the baseline. He gets fouled. Foul will be on Derek Chicolana. His first, team's first. Greater Allegheny will inbound. Comes out to Dizon. They pass it back over to Moody. Moody dribbles up high. Gives it off to Addison. Addison. Greater Allegheny passing around the perimeter. It's Moody on the far wing. Passes in to Dizon. He misses a layup. Follow up by Bird, and he puts it down. And Greater Allegheny on top, 4-2 here early in the first quarter.
That's always a big key for teams, is when you're able to get those offensive rebounds, you can get second chance points there.
Young and Holland passing around the perimeter for Lehigh Valley. Try to get it down inside. Taken away by Addison, behind the back dribble down the court. Driving the lane now. Underneath. Good dish underneath. No finish. Yeah, he was too far underneath. Was Ole Miss. And
knocked out of bounds.
Lehigh Valley knocked out. I wasn't sure if that was going to be a foul or they just knocked out of bounds.
Just knocked out of bounds.
Yeah, that was it. So Greater Allegheny's inbound. They have it. And that's Moody dribbling up high, top of the key. Dishes off to Addison. Takes the ball. Now he's dribbling around to the right side from NBA. Three-pointer off the rim.
He would have made that. That would have made some NBA threes look impressive.
He was almost at midcourt. But Lehigh Valley takes the ball down the other end. Taken away by Addison. Addison, three-on-three as they come down. Addison drives underneath. The reverse layup doesn't go. Taken down by Dizon. He puts it back. And it's 6-2, Greater Allegheny.
Addison is Mike as our... as Penguin announcer Mike Langwood would like to say, he picked his pocket like he was walking down Fifth Avenue.
Oh, and he went coast to coast to keep it in the hockey terms. But Lehigh Valley now trying to drive down in. And a nice driving floating shot by Brandon Holland. He makes it 6-4. And now it's Greater Allegheny with the ball. Ole Miss passes over to Addison and down along the baseline. Dizon tries to go up. He gets the ball knocked out of his hands, and here comes Lehigh Valley back the other way. Kelly with the ball. He passes off to the wing. Now they go around the corner. Three-pointer is on its way, and no good for Young. Rebound taken down by Greater Allegheny. And Moody dribbling up the court now. Down around the wing, passes off to Dies on, and a three-pointer again by Addison. Off the glass, no good. Rebound taken down by Chicolana. And Lehigh Valley dribbling up the court. Thought about the three-pointer was Kelly. Decides to go out top to Young. Young directing traffic now out by center court. Goes over to Chicolana. He lets go a two-pointer. No good from the baseline. Rebound taken down by Lehigh Valley. They battle for it underneath, and away with it comes Dizon. He passes off to Bird. Bird dribbles up the court, lets go from foul line, and he puts in two. And it's 8-4 now for Greater Allegheny. Chicolana drives the baseline. He gets fouled going to the hoop. Ooh. Chiklana gets the...
That's his second. Oh, he called it.
Oh. Okay, Peter Olmes with the... Well, they got it up on the board that it's... They're saying Dizon has the bird.
That's what I thought. That's what I thought initially.
Yeah, okay. Dizon with the foul. Okay. All right, now we got it. And at the line is Derek Chiklana. He misses his first. He rims it out. Second shot coming. Puts it up, rattles it off the cage, off the rim, taken down by Addison. And the ball goes off of Lehigh Valley, and it'll be Greater Allegheny's inbound.
On that last one, I think it was...
So Chiklana is 0 for 2 from the foul line. And now Greater Allegheny working the ball around the perimeter. Addison to London. London over to Bird. London in the ball game now for Greater Allegheny. Down low.
Count it. Bird got the basket.
Bird, okay.
We'll get an and one.
This is Aaron Bird at the line trying to complete the conventional three-pointer. As it stands, it's 10-4 right now. Greater Allegheny over Lehigh Valley. Bird. Greater Allegheny, nobody down there. Bird completes the conventional three-pointer, and it's 11-4, Greater Allegheny.
I've seen that a few times where you're going to, like, usually you see that in, like, the second half whenever you're so far ahead, you're not concerned if you don't get the board in order.
Or playing defense, yeah.
Yeah, you want to be more concerned with defense, but...
Nice drive there by Joel Torres for Lehigh Valley. Right down the lane, he puts the layup in, and it's 11-6. Addison and Moody now playing catch. He hands it off to London. London dribbling. Stops at the foul line. Passes over. Addison lets go one. It's a three-pointer from down on the wing, down in the corner. And it's suddenly 14-6, Greater Allegheny. Young dribbling the ball. Dishes off now to Torres. Torres stops at the foul line, pulls back, thought about the shot. And in fact, a little nice give and go there with Kelly. And Torres finishes off the layup, makes it 14-8. Addison now dribbling, top of the key, trying to go down the lane. Fed steady, passes off underneath, out to the wing. The dish comes. The three-pointer misses.
That would have been a deep two.
Oh, was it? Was he on the line?
The referee was saying, I couldn't see where, but he was probably on the line, but I saw the referee holding a two out.
Torres now dishes back. The three-pointer no good, taken down by Bird. And Greater Allegheny back up the court with a six-point lead. London now directing traffic, top of the key. Looks over, he finds Dizon. Dizon looked for somebody to pass to, trying to go over, but finally Moody takes it, goes off the glass, rebound. Taken down by Lehigh Valley, Chiklana, and Young is going to dribble it up the court. Trying to drive the lane, it's taken away by Addison. He gets the ball knocked out of his hands, but Addison still has the basketball. Trying to spin move down underneath the glass, gets his own rebound, puts it up and in. Addison. What a nifty spinning layup there on her follow-up. And it's 16-8. Greater Allegheny doubling up Lehigh Valley. Young with the drive. He gets fouled. And it's going to be Moody with the foul. And full timeout for Lehigh Valley will take the timeout.
Yeah, probably want to set something up here on this.
So, yeah, Greater Allegheny doubling up on the scoreboard on Lehigh Valley at this point, 16-8. And that was a floor foul, so there are no shots there for Lehigh Valley. Both teams with two fouls so far in the game, so team foul-wise.
Yeah, so pretty much what you might expect it or something there. It's like some might have expected with that.
All right, so on the court now for Greater Allegheny is Addison, Dizon, Bird, London, and Dixon. Chris Dixon seeing his first action tonight. Inbounding for Lehigh Valley is Jeff Garner. He gets it in to Torres. Torres now, after that foul, dribbling the ball right out near the timeline. It gets knocked away by Addison, but picked up by Lehigh Valley, Taj Williams. He drives the lane, dishes it back out, a three-pointer underway, and down by Shane Schmidt with a tray. That pulls Lehigh Valley to within five, 16-11, Greater Allegheny on top. And London now directing traffic top of the key, and they pass it around the perimeter. Dizon now goes back out to Dixon, back to London. London dribbling, has Addison in the near wing, in the corner, off his foot, and out of play. And Lehigh Valley will have the inbound. Coming back the other way, trailing by five here with a little over 12 minutes left in the first half. Torres now dribbling on the far wing. Brings it out, dishes back down, into the paint, comes back out to Torres. Controls the high pass, thought about the three-pointer, decided not to. Three-pointer underway, though, and missed by Chiklana. Follow-up was Taj Williams, and he puts it in for two. And here comes Greater Allegheny, and Dizon had the layup, and he decided to dish it, and it went off some Greater Allegheny players out of play.
Well, no, he got called for a charge.
Oh, did he get the charge?
Yeah, he got called for it.
Yes, it's up there, his second foul. Team's third. And now, Lehigh Valley, what a chance to pull within one or even tie the game up here. 16-13, Greater Allegheny on top. Torres trying to drive. And it's going to be Bird on the foul for Greater Allegheny. Team's fourth, his Bird's first. So inbounding now is Garner for Lehigh Valley. Torres from the foul line, he lets go of the two. It doesn't happen. Rebound comes all the way back out, and Lehigh Valley has it. One more time, a tray goes up for Garner, and he ties the game at 16 with 11:07 remaining here in the first half. Now Greater Allegheny on the attack. Addison, top of the key, decides to go over to the wing. Away, shot was blocked there by Lehigh Valley, and now Lehigh Valley can take the lead for the first time in the game as Torres dribbles up the court. Trying to get around Addison. That doesn't happen. Lehigh Valley loses the ball to Greater Allegheny. And now London dribbling up the court. Tries to drive. Dishes back out. Dixon decides not to take the three. Addison looking it over. Trying to drive the baseline. He dishes off to London. London off the glass. Taken down by Bird. Bird follows up and puts it in to make it 18-16, Greater Allegheny. Here comes Torres flashing up the court. This is a back out. It's Taj Williams with the ball. Top of the key. Passes off to Kelly. Kelly dribbling now to the far wing. Comes all the way across to Torres. Torres fakes the shot. Trying to spin his way into the hoop. Finds an open man by the way of Schmidt. The shot doesn't go, taken down by Addison. Passes it off now to London. dribbles up the court. And Danzel still dribbling. Tried to drive the baseline. Dishes out the bird at the foul line. He lets go the deuce. And down it goes, and it's suddenly a four-point lead again for Greater Allegheny, 2016.
Bird's ninth point of the game today. Fourth field goal. So, away from the play.
Greater Allegheny play over there. Looks like Danzel London over there.
I think he's actually going to get called for.
Saw the blocking foul indication, but I didn't see who it was on. It's going to be Lehigh Valley's ball. I think you're right. I think it's going to be London with the foul. Yep, it is. His first.
I think it always have to remember with college is that every time you foul, and he had it too. Now, it's not hurting them there because they're doing it early in the shot clock, but you don't want to do that late in the shot clock because then you're going to recycle. Now
right.
You're going to be able to. Okay, now we can set up an offensive, more of an offensive play here.
Addison picks up his first, team sixth. So next foul will put Lehigh Valley in the bonus situation. The tray goes off the rim.
He didn't get it. He couldn't stay in bounds.
No, and he stepped on the line. And Greater Allegheny will get the ball. And timeout for Greater Allegheny. It'll be a 30-second timeout. So, quickie here for Greater Allegheny with the score 20-16.
Yeah. I guess it.
Exactly 9:04 left.
Yeah.
I heard the PA system's playing. I was looking for a band over in the stands. Jeff, there's nothing over there.
Makes it sound like there's one here.
So it'll be Greater Allegheny ball now as they come out to the court. Back into the game is Peter Olmes. He will inbound. On the court with them is London. He's going to dribble the ball up the court. Under nine to go here, first half. Addison has it down on the baseline. Turns around, throws the ball up off the glass. He gets his own rebound, puts it up, and it's knocked out of bounds off of Lehigh Valley. Greater Allegheny will maintain possession with 32 seconds on the shot clock. Nice inbound right underneath the basket, and Bird lays it up off the glass and makes it a six-point lead for Greater Allegheny, 22-16. Jordan Young now passes off. And looks like Addison's going to get his second here on a away from the ball.
No.
It's going to be Dixon with the foul. It'll be his first, team seventh, but that will put Lehigh Valley on the line with a 1-1. Foul away from the ball. That's not a good thing if you're Greater Allegheny.
Yeah.
At the line is Schmidt on the 1-1, and he rattles the first one in. Makes it 22-17. See, put this down. And he does. He puts it down, and he immediately comes out of the game, being replaced by Derek Ciclana. And with the score 22-18, it will be London bringing the ball up the court. Danzel passes off to Addison. Addison, looking over the situation, is going to try to drive the net. He will bring it all the way in. Fingle roll doesn't go. Lehigh Valley takes the rebound, but he comes down out of bounds. And Greater Allegheny will maintain possession. Go here. Addison looking at Bird underneath the basket again. Decides to come way out top of the court. Pass it around. And now directing traffic. Passes over to Addison on the wing. A three-pointer on its way. Rattles in and out. Rebound taken down by Dixon, and he follows it up, puts it in, and it's 24-18, Greater Allegheny.
And one situation with that one.
Lehigh Valley, Taj Williams on the fast break on the inside. Late 24-20. Addison now passing off to Dixon. Dixon over to London. London up to Moody. Moody rattles it off the cage on a three-pointer, taken down by Kelly. Kelly dribs it up the court. Looks over, passes off to Williams. Taj Williams in the far wing, drives the baseline, dishes off. And up and in goes Chiklana to make it a two-point game, 24-22, 7-10 remaining here in the first half. London now dribbling. Danzel passes off to Moody. Moody, top of the key, drives the lane, dishes off, and Addison ends up with the ball. He tries to drive the baseline. He's going to get fouled by Taj Williams. And that will be Williams' first, team's third. And it will be inbounded by Petrie Addison. And Moody now with the ball dribbling. Eric passes off to London. And the ball goes off of Greater Allegheny, and Lehigh Valley now will inbound underneath their own basket. Jordan Young now finally crosses the timeline on the dribble, being hounded there by Moody. And he loses the ball as he was driving the lane, and I believe Greater Allegheny will get possession.
Yeah, Moody, nice play, blocked it off. He blocked it into his legs, and he kicked it out of bounds.
Yeah, Eric Moody was all over him, even from all the way down the court, and he tried to drive the lane. Lost his balance, the ball went off him, out of bounds, and now Addison dribbling up the court for Greater Allegheny. Finds the top of the key, passes off the Bird, he loses control, out of bounds right at the Lehigh Valley bench, and Lehigh Valley will inbound now. It'll be Torres inbounding, and Young now will dribble up the court. Jordan Young crosses the timeline again. On him is Moody, passes off to Torres, Torres to the top of the key. They pass it inside. Torres trying to spin and go up, and he lets it go. It's short, taken down by Addison. Petrie Addison.
I think I was partially blocked on that one. Looked like he got a finger on that.
Yeah, he did. Addison loses control, but there to pick up the package was London. He's dribbling now, top of the key, comes down into the corner. On the wing, lets go. The two, he drains it, and it's 26-22. Uncontested there. He just dribbled down into the corner and let her go. And slowly again, Young brings it up the court. Now he kicks it into gear. Top of the key, trying to drive the lane again. Dishes off to the far wing. He tries baseline, let's go. Two, misses. Petrie Addison with the rebound, and here comes London again up the court. Pulls up. Now he's going to set up shop on the half-court play. Directing traffic. Greater Allegheny moving around underneath. London dribbles to the left side. Fakes going in, looks for somebody to pass to, and they pass around. London gets it back. Now he's going to drive the hoop, goes all the way in and rolls off the rim. And back the other way comes Holland. Holland for Lehigh Valley. Passes back it out. They slow it down a little bit. Inside goes Chiklana. He tried to go up with it. And
blocked out of bounds.
I think Addison was blocked out by, you talk about blocking out, blocked out by the official, couldn't see the play, but I think Addison blocked it out of bounds. Lehigh Valley inbound with 23 on the shot clock. Speaking of 23, here comes Holland driving in, dishes out, spinorama move in the lane, and Kelly with two for Lehigh Valley. Again, a two-point game, 26-24 here at Wonderland Gymnasium on the beautiful campus of Penn State Greater Allegheny, out in McKeesport, White Oak area, if you've never been out here. Moody now, Eric Moody driving the lane, dishes back out. Dixon now driving the lane, he can't get it to go off the glass, he goes up for the rebound, it'll be a foul on Dixon going up for the rebound over the back. Yeah, calling it a push. That's Dixon's second, team's eighth, it'll be 1-1. For, looks like Kelly walking to the line for Lehigh Valley. Possibility here.
Like
possibility here of tying the game up one more time. It's been all Greer Allegheny's been in the lead the entire first half. We've got 4:03 remaining here, Jeff. Lehigh Valley came back and tied it up once. And Kelly misses his first rebound, taken down by Addison. So the two-point lead remains for the Lions of Greater Allegheny. Inside to Bird. Bird trying to spin around, go up. Knocked away by Lehigh Valley. Can they maintain control? They will. And here they come up the court. Jordan Young trying to drive all the way in. He goes up off the glass, followed up. Not to happen. Three on one for Greater Allegheny, and it's put up and in by London. Danzel London finishes off 28-24. And now Torres for Lehigh Valley drives in, dishes off right underneath to Chiclana, and he lays up the easy two.
Made that look really easy.
Oh, yeah. Two-point game again with just over 3 minutes to go here first half. Addison now walking it up, trying to go cross. Nice driving play there by Dizon, and a good feed by Addison. And Dizon lays it up. Returns to a four-point game again. Chiclana dribbles up. Still has the dribble. Tries a drive. It's knocked out by Greater Allegheny. And Jordan Young will inbound with 22 seconds on the shot clock for Lehigh Valley. And inbounds to Schmidt. Schmidt back to Young. Torres drives in. Misses the rebound. Taken down by Addison. He gets fouled, I believe. Well, yeah, Torres is going to get the foul on Addison. It's Torres' first foul. Fourth on Lehigh Valley. Only four fouls this half. With 2:33 remaining, inbounding will be Eric Moody. And he goes over to Danzel London.
Found it. That might be calling that nicely. It looks like he tackled him. Yeah.
That was a crackback block.
Yeah.
And London dribbling to the far side, lays it up in the air for Addison. Addison looks over the situation, goes around one, lays it up off the glass, a little bit short, taken down by Taj Williams. He'll dribble up the court for Lehigh Valley. Lays it off there for Garner. Garner back to Williams. Williams drives into the paint, lays it up off the glass, taken down by Dizon. And Moody will dribble it up the court. Moody tries to drive the lane off the glass. He gets fouled. It doesn't go, but Moody will be at the line for two. And it will be Brandon Holland, his first, team's fifth. But Eric Moody will shoot two. Moody drains his first one. 31-26 now. Back in the game is Kelly for Lehigh Valley. Moody now. Eric Moody dribbling the ball at the line, throws it up, and nothing but net to make it 32-26, a six-point lead for Greater Allegheny. Lehigh Valley now. Williams driving the net, or the hoop. He lays it up off the glass. Gets two back for Lehigh Valley. Eric Moody now crosses the timeline, back the other way. 90 seconds here in the first half. Dribbling in between legs, passes in the lane, back out to Moody, fakes the shot. Dribbles to his left, down the baseline, and he finds Dizon, back out to Addison, slips, but continues to drive in. He spins around, lays it up off the rim, and the rebound taken down by Williams, and Lehigh Valley coming back the other way. Under a minute to go, Williams goes all the way, off the glass, doesn't happen. Bird takes the rebound down, and Dixon dribbles up the court for Greater Allegheny. Lays it up for Addison for three. Addison, long three. Rebound comes right back out to him. He finds London out top. He shoots three from up top, and he drains the three for London. Dribbling up the court now is Garner. He crosses the timeline, and a whistle sounds.
2-1.
Offensive offensive foul for on Darrell Kelly for Lehigh Valley. That's the team six. Kelly's second. So the next foul will put Greater Allegheny in the bonus, but there's only 40 seconds left in the half.
A little more than 6 second difference between shot clock and game clock there. So
Addison now with the ball. Drives the lane. Dishes back off to Bird, but that's taken away by Williams. Dribbling up the court now is Kelly, and Bird fouls him. 33, that's Bird. That's his second foul, team's ninth, so it will be a one-on-one for Lehigh Valley, and at the line will be Darrell Kelly. .3 seconds remaining in the half. Kelly throws up the first one. It's short, taken down by Dizon for Greater Allegheny. Eric Moody slowly up the court. 20 to go, first half. 35-28, Greater Allegheny. Moody back out to London. London drives the lane, dishes back out to Moody. Moody for two, off the rim. Rebound taken down by Madison, out of his hands is Garner, and up comes Lehigh Valley with one to go. The three-pointer is up and good from Shane Schmidt. The tray goes down, and that closes it for Lehigh Valley. They bring it to within 4 points, but Greater Allegheny, after one half, is on top of Penn State Lehigh Valley by the score of 35-31. Don't go away. Come right. We'll come right back and see if we can't get you some stats in the second half.
I'm Janelle Wright, a Panera Bread customer. I am the mother of four children, and I'm a professional violinist. After eating the breakfast power sandwich, I know that I'm fueled for the day and I feel satisfied. To me, this is the only fresh, wholesome option out there because the competitors have something that's processed that they're warming up in the microwave. What I love about the breakfast power sandwich are the wonderful ingredients. It's the all-natural egg, the Vermont white cheddar, and smoked ham on freshly baked whole grain bread, something under 350 calories, and that's awesome. Panera Bread, make today better.
My sport is football, but my passion is education. My name is Nnamdi Asamoah, and this is how I live United. I see too many kids miss out on moving up. Kids who could go on to college, but just need that extra little push. So every year, I take promising high school students on a college tour. We check out the dorms, the library, meet some professors, find out where the best late night grub stops are. It shows them that there's a whole world beyond their own. But what's even better is that most of these kids decide college is for them. I'm Nnamdi Asamoah. I show kids that a higher education means a brighter future. So when it comes to living United, I don't just wear the shirt, I live it. Join me.
It takes all of us working together to make a difference. Find out how you can live United for education. Give, advocate, volunteer. Go to liveunited.org. Brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
This is Charlie Batch, and you're listening to Champ Sports Network, where champions are heard.
Today in school, I learned a lot. In chemistry, I learned that no one likes me. In biology, I learned that I'm fat and stupid. In English, I learned that I'm disgusting. And in gym, I learned that I'm pathetic and a joke. The only thing I didn't learn in school today is why no one ever helps.
Kids witness bullying every day. They want to help, but they don't know how. Teach them how to stop bullying and be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov. A message from the Ad Council.
Taking that time right behind my back, and I'm
Back to Wonderland Gymnasium here on the campus of Greater Allegheny, Penn State, Greater Allegheny. And I'm Al Esch alongside Jeff Wink bringing you the action here. We're at the break with Penn State, Greater Allegheny on top of Penn State, Lehigh Valley by the score of 35-31. And I think Jeff's got some pertinent information on how we got to this point.
Yeah, here we got Derlicky, Chiklana, he's got six points. Derek Kelly with two. Tajah Williams with six. Holland with two. Torres with four. Gardner with three. And Shane Smith leading Lehigh Valley scorers with eight points, total of 31 for Greater Allegheny. Dizon has six. Aaron Bird leading all scorers with 11 points. Moody with four. Addison with five. London with two. And
seven.
Or seven. And Dixon with two. Total 35 on that one.
So, yeah, and you go back up to Lehigh Valley. Shane Schmidt with the leading scorer for them for the first half with 8 points. He hit two of three from three-point land for his six of his 8 points, so figure out how he's doing it. And for Aaron Bird, he's doing it all from two-point land. He's five of six from field goal range, and he didn't even try a three-pointer, so he's doing it from inside. Of course, Aaron Bird's a big boy, so he's got that wide body, and he's tall, so he's not going to be shooting too many three-pointers.
Well, Shane Smith, here's where I have a big key with this. Greater Allegheny, 3 of 3 from the line. Big stat there.
Right.
Lehigh Valley, 2 of 6, all two from Shane Schmidt. He's got both. He's the one that made both of the free throws,
yeah. Everybody else, Kelly and Chiklana, both 0 for 2 from the line. And that's not helping. That's 4 points, and guess what, Jeff?
Yeah,
that's the difference in the game right now. So, all right. So I think
Greater Allegheny holding the edge on rebounds, 24-17 so far.
Right. That's, you know, you'd think the athleticism of Addison will be taking down a lot of those rebounds, but a lot of them have been Birds.
They're tied each. There,
yeah, each half
have
four.
It's going around it's going down the, just down the whole line there. But the difference is that I see are on the offensive rebounds. Greater Allegheny's getting the second and third opportunities. You know, and you always preach, you got to defend your own glass. Give them the one shot, and that's it. Give them out of there.
Yeah, you talk about that, Jeff. Offensive rebounds. Lehigh Valley has three, all three of them by Taj Williams. And Greater Allegheny, their offensive rebounds, they have nine. And, again, defensive rebounds, pretty even 15 for Greater Allegheny. Yeah. Lehigh Valley has 14. But, yeah, it's the offensive glass for two teams. That and the free throws that are making the difference of this game for Greater Allegheny.
Everyone says, like, well, how's the offensive different from defense? If you get a defensive rebound, the other team's not going to shoot the ball again unless they steal it from you. I didn't see too many of those go around.
So, all right. We'll step away, and the teams are coming back out on the court here. We're warming up a little bit, and we'll be back for second half action here from Wonderland Gymnasium on the campus of Greater Allegheny.
Some statistics are surprising. Some are unbelievable. And some are simply unacceptable. Right now, nearly 30% of U.S. students aren't finishing high school. Nearly 30%. And that's the average. In many places, it's even higher than that. And fixing it is a responsibility that we all share. This is President Obama, and I urge everyone, not just parents, but friends and neighbors and family members, to take responsibility for encouraging the high school students in your communities, to support them, challenge them, push them a little, and do whatever it takes to help them make it through. Because this is one statistic we simply can't afford to ignore.
You can do your part by going to boostup.org and sending an email, a text message, or even a wake-up call to a student at risk of dropping out. Go to boostup.org and provide the boost that's needed to make it to graduation. A message from the U.S. Army and the Ad Council.
I'm Scott Davis, the head of Panera Bread's culinary team, and I want to tell you about our new spinach power salad. The idea behind this salad is to give you sustainable energy to get you through the day. We started with baby spinach. Can't get better than that for a green. Roasted mushrooms, take some olive oil, you season them up, heat them over the fire real hot, caramelize them, add a hard-boiled egg to that, a little applewood smoked bacon, great smoky Vidalia onion vinaigrette that we created, and you top it off with some frizzled onions just for some fun. The new spinach power salad, only at Panera Bread. And don't forget Panera for all your catering needs.
Janelle Wright, a Panera Bread customer. I am the mother of four children, and I'm a professional violinist. After eating the breakfast power sandwich, I know that I'm fueled for the day and I feel satisfied. To me, this is the only fresh, wholesome option out there because the competitors have something that's processed that they're warming up in the microwave. What I love about the breakfast power sandwich are the wonderful ingredients. It's the all-natural egg, the Vermont white cheddar, and smoked ham on freshly baked whole grain bread. Something under 350 calories, and that's awesome. Panera Bread, make today better.
My sport is football, but my passion is education. My name is Namdi Asamoah, and this is how I live United.
Welcome back to Wonderland Gymnasium. on the campus. I've said it before, on the campus of Penn State Greater Allegheny. Getting ready to bring you the action second half with Penn State Greater Allegheny on top of Penn State Lehigh Valley by the score of 35-31. I'm Al Lesh alongside Jeff Wink. Just to let you know that your Greater Allegheny Lions will be back in action here on Champ Sports Network. Bring your sweetheart and listen to the game. It's on Valentine's Day against Schuylkill right here.
It'll be a doubleheader with the women.
With the women as well, right. So that's next Friday afternoon. I believe it's...
No, later.
14th, 3 p.m. it says.
That is...
That's what it says.
Okay.
And that will be the last game of the regular season, and then the playoffs start, the conference playoffs. So, all right, looks like we're ready to get underway here. About 20 seconds, second half action.
Like each team starting out with their starters.
Yeah, it looks like. Yeah, I was just looking at that. Yep, all the starters are on the floor for both teams. And it should be greater...
Well, we have one problem. We don't have officials.
No, where are the officials at? Yeah. Man, all the teams are looking
teams
around.
Yeah, they're looking around like, where are the officials? That's what we're waiting on.
In hockey, where's the buzzer? Call them on her. Where are the officials?
We can't get that lucky with hockey.
Well, here they come. They're walking down the hallway now. It's two of them anyway. All right, we've done hockey games with two. they're playing the Jeopardy song.
Here's number three.
Oh, okay. There he is. I believe it should be Greater Allegheny's ball.
No. They're pointing that way. That'd be Lehigh Valley's ball.
No, Lehigh Valley shot at that hoop first.
First half, they'll shoot at this hoop second half.
Yeah, but then somebody else said white ball, so I don't know. Well, they're talking about it right now. We'll see who inbounds from across the other side of the court.
They're going to give it to the Greater Allegheny.
Yeah. And, yep, it's going to be Dizon. Is going to inbound, and he does. He gets it over to Eric Moody, and Moody will dribble it up. Underway here, second half. 35-31, Greater Allegheny. It's Dizon with the ball. He passes over to Olmes. Over to Moody. Moody back out the bird to Olmes. Olmes inside to Addison. Underneath all by himself, and he turns around, puts it off the glass, and makes it 37-31.
I'm not going to stop someone 6-6 that close.
No.
No, Bert!
Man.
I don't care what level of basketball you're talking about.
It's Young now with the ball, trying to pass it inside. Knocked down by Bird for Greater Allegheny. And here comes Moody, pushing it up court. He's one against the world, though, and he turns it back and slows the play up. Brings it back out. High up in the forecourt. Passes over to Dizon. Over to Olmes. Back to Moody. Inside to Addison. Addison turns around, lays it up. Can't get it in. Gets his own rebound, though. Brings it right back to the hoop. And it gets knocked out of his hands. And here comes Lehigh Valley back the other way. 37-31. They pass it out to Kelly. Kelly kicks it back out top to Jordan Young, the 5'11 freshman guard. Passes over to Holland. Holland driving the lane. He puts it up. He gets fouled. It doesn't go. But Holland's going to the line. Foul was on Eric Moody. Will be his second, team's first. And Holland will shoot two. Trailing by six, throws his first one up and in. 5-point lead now for Greater Allegheny. Have never trailed in this game. Been tied twice. And Holland drains the second. Back to a 4-point lead for Greater Allegheny. And Moody will dribble it up court. Pushes it to the left side. Passes off to the wing to Bird. Bird lets fly to two. And he drains a long two. And it's 39-33. From the left wing. And it'll be Young now bringing it up court. Passes off to Holland. Holland pushes back to Young. Over to Kelly. Kelly drive into the paint. Throw up the hook. That doesn't happen. And Addison brings down his a rebound. He's going to bring it down the court, go right into the paint, and he gets fouled. Should be a... So it'll be Kelly on the foul. It'll be his third, team's first, and Addison will be at the line for two. Petrie Addison. Drains the first one, nothing but net. Madison in double figures now. Has the double-double, and he bounces the second shot off the front of the rim, and it's a 40-33 lead for Greater Allegheny as Young dribbles down into the corner. Looking to drive the baseline. Doesn't happen. He gets turned away. He passes off to Chiclada. He drives into the paint. Has nowhere to go. Throws it up. It's knocked away by Dizon. He comes away with it. Hands off to Eric Moody. He pushes it up court. Stops at the top of the key. Passes over to Olmes. Down in the corner to Addison. Let's fly a three. And it's off the rim. Picked up by Bird. He knocks it out of bounds.
I tried to save it.
Yeah,
he must have been really far out of bounds. He couldn't get that one in.
I keep looking for the line closer to the bleachers over there on the other side, but it's way far away from the bleachers, and I was thinking he had more room to run, and he didn't. But Lehigh Valley up the court again. It's Torres now. In the lineup, we'll dribble it up. He tries to drive a lane, tries to lay it off the glass. That's knocked aside by Addison, but it comes right out to Taj Williams. He lays it up. That's no good, and it goes out of bounds to Lehigh Valley. 7-point lead now.
The second one, Bird, was just a little bit further back than he thought he was. He knocks it. It goes. It hits almost like he hits the line. They're like, no, you didn't get back in.
Williams now dishes off to Young, over to Chiclana, back out to Young, working the perimeter, thought about the three-pointer, pitches in to Chiclana. Chiclana dishes off to the far side, three-pointer underway, and it rattles down from Torres to make it a 4-point game again. Olmes dishes off to Moody, and Moody one more time will bring it up court. Eric Moody now down in the near wing. Tries to go down the lane. He gets it knocked out of his hand. Gets the ball back. Dishes off to Bird. He can't go up. That's rejected. And here comes Williams. Down to Holland. Holland goes up. And in. And he gets fouled. 2-point game. Could be one. As Holland goes to the line to complete, try to complete the conventional 3-point play. The foul goes against Ole Miss. It will be his first, team second. Olmes and Moody will come out, and in will come Williams,
London,
and London.
Williams has seen his first action of the game as Holland converts the 3-point.
To make it a 1-point game, and Greater Allegheny now with London dribbling up, passes off to Addison. Petrie Addison dribbles to the far side. Pitches down to London, goes to Bird down underneath, goes up, gets his own rebound, rattles it off the rim, gets it back again. He goes up and puts it in and gets fouled, and Bird will be at the line. And the foul will go against Jordan Young, and Bird will try to complete the conventional 3-point play with the score 42-39 in favor of Greater Allegheny. Bird goes up and off the back of the rim. Chiclana, the 6'6 freshman, brings it down. Passes up. Taj Williams trying to drive the baseline and dies on the holding foul. That should be a floor foul. It is. And Lehigh Valley will inbound. And that's the third foul in Dizon. Inbound to Holland. Holland, let's go to three, and it rattles in and out. Rebound by Addison, and he dishes it off to London. London back to Addison, makes a move, goes down the lane, lays it up and in, and Addison and London combine to make it a five-point lead for Greater Allegheny.
It almost seems like... 30 it's almost like that whenever Lehigh Valley gets to a certain point, it's almost like their Greater Allegheny just starts pulling away again.
Yeah.
So it's like you can see that there, and you're like, oh, what's...
Yeah, it's almost like they're toying with them.
Yeah. I like to say sometimes when you see a team like that, it's almost like they always get to a point where it's like almost like that pool hall hustler has been trifling with the victim and he's going a little bit too long. Now it's like, okay, now time to put him away.
Can you get our cushion back? Aaron Bird on the court. He's the oldest player on the court at this time. He's a 6'2 forward, senior forward. But Lehigh Valley has the ball. A little give and go. Doesn't happen. Young gets it back, though. 20 on the shot clock. Dribbles through the paint. Passes off to Torres. Torres coming right down the middle. Bird set up.
Over the back!
And the rebound put in. Taj Williams with the put back for Lehigh Valley to make it 44-41. Back to a three-point lead. Addison now goes all the way. He throws it in to the Greater Allegheny bench.
It's one of the guys that are sitting on the bench there.
They could have picked anybody. I think it was intended for 6 foot junior guard Matt Williams, but it was well over his head. .1458 remaining in a 3-point game. And
I said sometimes they pass it and they go to the bench. He's like, he's throwing it to the coach.
Torres drives the lane, gets the ball knocked out of his hands, but he's the last to touch it, and Greater Allegheny will come up with possession. Dixon and London have some words at midcourt. London now dribbling it up for Greater Allegheny. Lehigh Valley in their 2-3 defense. The ball drives the lane, dishes out to Addison, backs up for the three-pointer. Let's fly, nothing but net. Addison for three, and it's suddenly 47-41, Greater Allegheny. And here comes Taj Williams again, dishes off to Derek Chiklana, and he finishes it off for the two-point play.
Lehigh Valley's going to trade baskets. They can't be the ones getting the two and giving up threes.
We're exactly, yeah. And Addison's starting to get the range from three-point land, so... Matt Williams now far side, drives into the line, passes off to Addison. Addison this time drives in, he lays it up, a little bit short, taken down by Chiklana. He passes off now to Garner. Garner gives it up to Torres, driving the baseline. He lays it up off the glass, and it's suddenly a two-point game as Lehigh Valley closes it to 47-45. Timeout. Greater Allegheny. It'll be a full timeout. And with 13:41 remaining and a two-point game, Greater Allegheny's got to put the stoppers on this little comeback here from Lehigh Valley.
And I've seen a lot of coaches the other team getting on a run, but they're ahead, so they will not call the timeout. And They won't call the timeout till they finally get behind, and I always say, well, that's a little late at this point. You could have stopped it earlier.
Stop the bleeding. Yeah, and you can't take the timeouts with. And I understand he's trying to conserve till it's late in the game and you really need them, and then you don't have them. But, I mean, this is a critical – you're right, Jeff. It's the critical time to take timeout, stop the bleeding, and turn the game around. And, I mean,
he must have thought it was a critical timeout because he took his – he took his time out and made it a full time out.
All right, ready to go here. It will be Great Allegheny Ball right in front of us. Inbounding. This is off to London. London now brings it across. Top of the key, over to Addison, back to London. Inside to Bird at the foul line. Bird looking around, turns around, let's go to two-pointer. Rebound by Addison. Let's go, but Addison gets it back again. Back up again, and Dixon for two. And there's his offensive rebounds, Jeff, and Greater Allegheny just in command on under the boards. It's Torres now with the ball. It goes off his foot. And it'll be out of bounds. It'll be Greater Allegheny's ball. .1306 remaining. It's 49-45 here in the second half. Greater Allegheny on top. And one more time. Mr. London will bring it down court. Passes off to Addison. Up high, top of the key. Matt Williams now, far side, and he goes all the way across to Addison. They almost, Torres almost,
he traveled.
Almost read that, but he comes down with it. You're right, Jeff. He back foot slid, and Addison was traveling, Petrie Addison. So turnover.
Go, get back.
And here comes Lehigh Valley, right down lane, dishes off. Knocked out of side by Addison. Chiglana thought he had a layup, and Addison hit it away. And now here comes Lehigh Valley back again. Dishes off, and this time, slam a jam a time for Derek Chiglana. Makes it a two-point game. A nice dish there from Jordan Young to give Chiglana the opportunity to slam a jam in that one. Addison now for Greater Allegheny with a two-point lead. Pass off to Matt Williams, near side. They pass down to London. London steps back for the two-pointer. He drains it. His foot was on the line. I looked at the official. He pulled the line. But it's a four-point lead. Again, they tried that same play. Young and Chiglana. It didn't happen. That time, Greater Allegheny read it and knocked it out of bounds, but Lehigh Valley will maintain possession. Inbounding underneath the basket, the offensive basket. Young dishes off to Gardner. Gardner tried to go to Chiglana. Gardner gets it back. Three-point land out to Young now. Setting up shop. Down to 15 to go in the shot clock. Chiglana with the ball. Looking 10 to go. Drives the net. Turns off the rim. Rebound taken down by Dixon. And London will push the court for Greater Allegheny. Hands off to Moody. Moody back to London. Break down lane. Back to Moody. Two-pointer underway. Off the rim. Taken down by Lehigh Valley's Garner. And Young will push it up the court. Pass off to Garner. Three is underway. Off the rim. Rebound by Bird. And London dribbling up over the timeline. Pulls up and sets up the half-court game. To Bird at the foul line. Bird over to Moody. Moody hands off to London. London dribbles back the other way. Right down the lane. Dishes off. Oh, what a dish! To Addison, coming down the baseline, and he softly off the glass makes it 53-47 in favor of Greater Allegheny. And Young now for Lehigh Valley trying to set up shot. Torres fakes the shot, goes down, and there's a foul called as Derek Chiglana was driving the net on the baseline. And it's going to be a foul on Eric Moody. It will be his third, team's fourth. With 10:42 remaining here, second half, 53-47 lead for Greater Allegheny. Reset that shot clock as Garner gets the ball all the way out up top to Schmidt. Schmidt to Torres. Foul line gets bumped, hands it off to Schmidt. Schmidt dribbles in, lays it off the glass. Blocking foul on Addison. He's on the court, and he's slow getting up. Finally, or no, that wasn't Addison, that was Bird. Addison helped Bird up. And Bird will take the blocking foul on Schmidt. Schmidt will go to the line for two, and that's the third foul on Bird, the fifth on the lines of Greater Allegheny. And the lines of Lehigh Valley are at the line. Schmidt shooting his first. He drains that one.
I don't think Shane Schmidt's the kind of guy you want to send to the free throw line.
No.
At this point, he's putting points on the board without the clock moving.
No, just drained the second one. Makes it a four-point game. And I've never seen this Shane Schmidt before, but he looks like one of these pure shooters. He's just the kid that can put it up. And Addison now driving lane for Greater Allegheny. And he draws the foul. He'll go to the line for two. It will be Jordan Young on the foul. It's his second, team's third. But Addison at the line for two. Nothing but net on the first one. Addison yelling at his teammates. They all pull out. And Addison, Petrie Addison drains the second one. Back up to a six-point lead for Greater Allegheny. London hounding Jordan Young for Lehigh Valley Lions. They pass it in. Kelly takes it back out to Schmidt. Schmidt back out to Young, and they reset with 10 to go here in the shot clock. Young, top of the key, all the way down to Kelly, loses control, out of bounds. Then Kelly turns it over. And Greater Allegheny will come back up the court the other way with a six point lead. 9:49 remaining here. London dribbling it up. Passes to Addison. Addison finds an opening, drives right down the lane. It's going to be an offensive foul on Petrie Addison. That'll be Addison's second. And the team six, so with basically half the half left,
yeah.
Lehigh Valley will be in the bonus situation the rest of the way. Young now dribbling down, passes off to Derek Ciclana, drives toward the net, taken away by Greater Allegheny Bird, passes back to London. London pushing it up across the timeline. London now setting up shot. Hands off to Addison. Petrie Addison, top of the key, gives back to London. London thought about the three, passes inside for Bird. He goes up over the back, and they're going to say out of bounds, Greater Allegheny. Bird went up, faked the shot, and one of the Lehigh Valley players was laying all over Bird, but no call made. Young now passes down to Torres in the corner for Lehigh Valley. Passes back to Young, standing there watching the shot clock and watching his players run around. Ciclana trying to get some open space, and Young dribbling to the top of the key. He lets fly a two. 55-51 now, Greater Allegheny on top as Young drained that one. Moody now passes off to London, over to Addison. Addison lets go a three, and he rattles that off the rim. Almost went down. And they're going to say, off of Lehigh Valley, that was a great play there. Was that Dixon made that play?
I think so.
The ball was going out of bounds. He was last to touch it, and the Lehigh Valley player was in front of him, and he whipped the ball off of the Lehigh Valley player and out of bounds. So Greater Allegheny has the ball. Petrie has the ball, Addison has the ball knocked out of his hands. London has it now. Pass it down to Addison. Petrie Addison turns, puts it up and off the rim. It's going to be Torres on the holding foul, and Addison will shoot two. That's Torres' second, team's fourth for Lehigh Valley. Addison. He's like automatic at the line, Jeff. They're pure shots from the line. They're hitting the net, maybe grazing the rim as they go down. As that one did, too. He gets them both.
Almost like if he hits anything, he's trying to hit that. And that's an unusual combination. You don't usually see that with a big guy.
No. Torres now knocked away by London and taken right back by Young for Lehigh Valley. Pit dishes down to Chiclana, and he slam-a-jammas that one. And it's the same combination as they did before. Young to Chiclana for two. Underneath, it's a four-point game, 57-53. Greater Allegheny on top. London now drives, kicks it back to Bird. London gets it back. Bird and London and Moody exchange places. Addison now driving the baseline, has it knocked out of his hands. Here comes Schmidt for Lehigh Valley now. Pulls up shop, sets it up. Holland now driving the baseline, turns, sends it over to Schmidt. Schmidt pulls up, lets go the two, and he drains that one, and it's a two-point game, 57-55. Lehigh Valley trying to come back here with just under seven to go. Moody now drives, turns away, goes down the paint, hands off to Bird. Bird has it knocked out of his hands, goes right into Addison's. He puts it up, he gets fouled. And I believe that one's going to go on Young. Yep. Jordan Young gets the foul. Team fifth. Young's third. So Addison at the line one more time in a two-point game, 57-55. Addison rattled that one off the front of the rim, Jeff. Whoa. Take a picture of that one. You're not going to see that very often.
Yeah.
He's got another one here. Make it a three-point game. And he rattled that one down. 58-55. And Lehigh Valley, by way of Jordan Young, will bring it up the court. Chiclana goes right down underneath. Young looking for him. Dribbling. Comes back to Schmidt. Schmidt lets go to three. Off the back of the rim. Tip back up. And Moody brings down the rebound for Greater Allegheny. Dribbles up top of the key, backs it out. Passes over to Bird, thinks about the three, passes back to Moody, over to London, near side. Goes to Addison, down on the baseline. Driving, puts it up, taken away by Williams, and here comes Young pushing up court. And we got a foul behind the play. I believe this is going to be against Taj Williams.
No,
it's going to be on. It will be on Petrie Addison, his third, team seventh. So that will put Taj Williams at the line. I knew Taj Williams was going to be involved there somewhere. He's shooting one and one here. First one's up, and he rattles it down. 2-point game. Williams could make it a 1-point game. With just 6:01 remaining. Williams goes up with the second one, and that goes off the front of the rim. Moody will come down rebound. Greater Allegheny still with a 2-point lead. Moody now passes back to Addison. Addison looks over the situation, begins to drive, backs it back for a 3-pointer. He lets go the three and drains that one. And timeout, Greater Allegheny. It's a full timeout with a 5-point lead, Greater Allegheny. Addison draining that three-pointer. Drove in, Jeff, stepped inside the three-point land and said, no, I'm going back. He stepped back two steps and let fly.
Yeah, no, I'd almost like to see this, see what they have with this. I'm looking at the thing here. It looks like Petrie Addison played the whole, and Bird played the whole game so far. I don't know if they've come out yet. Been basically doing the subs for three guys.
Oh, yeah. You're right. 20 minutes for the first half, and they haven't come out in the second half. So Bird and Addison. Addison the junior and Bird the senior. Playing the game, as they say, getting the minutes.
Yeah.
Looks like Nick Dizon back in the lineup for Greater Allegheny. He has three fouls.
Now sometimes you got to put these close games, you got to throw caution to the wind with your better players here.
Yeah, we have three fouls, though. It's under 6 minutes to go. You got 5:42 remaining. It's time. You can put him in, let him play out the time. They did okay without him in the lineup, but with him in the lineup, that's when they stretched out their lead. So
yeah.
Young now for Lehigh Valley, driving the baseline, knocked out of his hand. Bird comes away with it, passes off to Moody. Moody slowly up, crosses the timeline. Moody in London now, up top. They pass down into the corner for Addison. Addison one-handing out the Bird at the foul line. He lets go the two, off the back of the rim. Rebound by Dyson. No, taken away by Young. Got inside of him. Jordan Young now passes off to Holland. Back to Young. Young turns it away. Top of the key. Over to Williams. Taj Williams driving the lane. He lays it up and in as he drove right down the lane from the corner and makes it a three-point game. 61-58. Greater Allegheny still in the lead. Moody now driving for Greater Allegheny. Right down. Doesn't go, but Bird gets the rebound. The net putback doesn't go, and Holland now passes up to Taj Williams. Gets around Addison, passes off to Chiklana. They dish it out for the three-pointer up off the rim, and Addison comes down with the rebound for Greater Allegheny. Trying to go all the way. He gets fouled on the court. And that will be Taj Williams, his second, team sixth. That was a floor foul. So next foul will put Greater Allegheny at the line for 1-1. Kelly back in, Schmidt out, Holland out, and Torres back in for Lehigh Valley. And London now and Moody exchange passes. Up top, they go down to Addison in the corner now. Thought about the three, backs in on the dribble, turns, goes back out to Bird at the foul line. He drives the lane, gets the ball, gets knocked out of his hand, picked up by Addison, and he rattles it in for two. And it's 63-58, under four to go here, and Lehigh Valley's Jordan Young brings it up the court. Goes into the far corner. We got a timeout, Lehigh Valley. It'll be a full timeout for Lehigh Valley. And if my calculations are right, Jeff, I've got both teams have taken three timeouts, which leaves them with two left. Unless I'm missing one, both teams have 1 30-second and one full left.
Yeah.
So, and we got 3:50 to go in a 63-58 game. Wow. It's a pretty good game.
Yeah.
That's what I expected. Two teams pretty evenly matched. Greater Allegheny. But the surprising thing is, though, Greater Allegheny has never been behind in this game.
That's sort of a little bit of a surprise there.
They've led the whole game. Now, Lehigh Valley came back and tied it up once or twice.
I think three times. But one of those was
when they start.
Which it was 2-2. You technically got to count that, but I sometimes say, no, let's not count that one.
Every time Lehigh Valley make a run, like you said before, it was like Greater Allegheny turn the switch, then spread it out again, and it's back to a 5-point lead. Young now for Lehigh Valley as we're back underway with 15 on the shot clock. Backs it out to three-point land. Chiklana inside, off the rim, and rebound taken down by Petrie Addison for Greater Allegheny. And Moody slowly up the court. Now he picks up the pace, crosses the timeline in a 5-point game. Moody goes to Addison down in the corner. Williams all over him. Addison works his way to the middle. He goes up the underhand layup. He gets fouled by Williams. And that will be Williams' third, team seventh. Addison will be at the line for two, though. That was a shooting foul. Addison rattles that one down. And again, Greater Allegheny, nobody on the foul in the lane. Everybody's back in the backcourt. Addison off the front of the rim on that one. So he goes one for two again. 64-58. 3:13 remaining here in the second half, in the game. It's Jordan Young for Lehigh Valley. State Lehigh Valley desperately needs to get something going here if they want to get back into this. Chiclana on the baseline gets trapped, gets it out to Young. He tries to drive the lane, foul on the floor. And Dyson and Moody were there. Moody's going to get called for the foul. And Young will be at the line for a 1-1.
That's his fourth. He's going to have to come out now.
Moody.
Yeah.
Yeah, Moody does come out. And in the lineup goes Ole Miss. So I'd say he's probably out for about a minute. That's about all I'd leave him out for. And then bring him back in.
Well, you see how it develops here.
Yeah.
I mean, if you go on a 10-0 run during that time, maybe you just say, okay, take a breather at this point.
Young misses the first part of the 1-on-1. Greater Allegheny has it. London driving the lane. It rolls off the rim. And Williams comes down with the ball for Lehigh Valley. Young misplayed the ball. Gets it right back. A three-pointer up from Torres. Taken down by Addison. Petrie Addison now dribbling it up the court. The man brings it up. Has an opening, drives the lane. He goes off the side.